Well, it's about 1 week to go. The boat's all set up. Solar panel, lights, the magic hook. I got UHF, VHF, and the sunshades in the back, and the comms, compass, solar charger, and give it your battery, everything. Well, I'm packed up and ready to go. The boat's all packed. John 12's ready to go. So tomorrow I'll launch from Ham Dam. Here's the first look at the river. Just about to launch. There's the river. But there's Marie. See you later. Well, it's day two.
I'm gonna try and make coral with today. I'm having trouble with my phone. The Wi-Fi is playing up, and I keep losing stuff.
This is day two. Still just as ugly. Pull up for a cuppa. You find places set up like this all the way along. People just, no one here, hope they don't mind me using it. Just having a cuppa. Here's the mighty vessel. Thank you.
At Yarrawonga, nice little town.
Through the weir. Two really cool guys. And there we go. Well, I'm through the weir. So that's a big day, through Lake Mawala and through the weir at Lake Mawala. Man, watch out. But very picturesque. I'm going to have a swim now. Thank you. Oh yeah. Yeah, I almost abandoned it because of this motor. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is where I've been holed up for the last week, sitting on the banks of the river. There's my boat, minus the Chinese engine. That's where I'm staying. There's my little humpy, my seat. Happy? What are you doing, Happy? Show us how you do your Happy walk. What are you doing, Happy? What are you doing? What are you doing, Happy? You got a sore yet, sore, isn't it? Well, I've been broken down here at Echuca now since last Sunday. It's now Friday, so that's what 5 days I've been sitting here, camped on the riverbank here. The Chinese motor crapped itself, the steering bearings collapsed, and it was just shaking itself to pieces, so I got rid of that. I thought I'd sort it out now before I headed up to Swan Hill, because it's a long stretch of wilderness between here and there. And better to sort it out here than keep going and break down in the wild. So anyway, I'll just show you where I'm camped, and hopefully the engine will be here today. I'll just give you a look around the camp. There's the boat. You can see I'm sort of staying on the bank here. There's that. There's my little tent. And my chair. And there's the mighty Murray in all its beauty. Thank you.
lift over the rear 26. Once again, another beautiful spot. This looks good enough for tonight. Lovely.
know tomorrow. Time you have is time you borrow. If you're smart, why did you follow? Gone. No chance to think of what she done. No chance to see the morning come. Do I have to spell it out? I'm in love with a dead woman, deader than the dead of night. I'm in love with a dead woman in my life. And in her way she had to slow me, had to stop me, had to show me. She had one secret only, if you love me you should know me. John, she said, I can't give you love because I'm dead. I count the seconds in my head. Do I have to spell it out? I'm in love with a dead woman, deader than the dead of night. I'm in love with a dead woman in my life. And as I sing about her story, I can hear her voice call me. Stay away from me, my lover, from a cliff. I see her falling down. Gave me a chance to look around. And I touched lightly on the ground. Do I have to spell it out? I'm in love with a dead woman, deader than the dead of night. I'm in love with a dead woman in my life. And when you're cold, you have to go. And at that time, yes, you will know. People come and people go. As one love dies, another grows. John, she said, I can't give you love because I'm dead. I count the seconds in my head. I'm in love with a dead woman, deader than the dead of night. I'm in love with a dead woman in my life.
So you're moving along. It's about as fast as the Chinese engine. Can't do it for too long though, because you drift into snags. Got engine troubles again. I think it's just a block carburetor. I hope so. This section just after Swan Hill is really tricky. I'd recommend getting one of these chart books.
very shallow. Sandbars and reefs everywhere. You can see here, see the water on that side and the water on that side, and you can see there's a flat bit in the middle. That's the channel. So I have to cut close to the bank here. See, that's all a bit sandbar, see that? On here.
Day 22, just outside from Naya, coming down from Swan Hill. If anyone's thinking about doing the river, is a really bad stretch. I'd strongly recommend you get those river charts, because Google Maps is useless, and it's a very, very shallow. You got down to 1.5 or 0.5 of a meter. So yeah, strongly recommend you get those river charts if you're thinking about doing it. Invaluable. Beautiful morning, nice sandy beach. Always find a sandy beach. If you get stuck in the mud, it probably can't say that on YouTube. There's down there, there's a pump. Yeah, if you can see it. But anyway. There's thousands of them, and they go all night, sucking the river dry. Anyway, better get packed and going.
You've got a putt through here, man, seriously. There's crap everywhere and it's shallow. See the channel on the right there? Snag there. The bit you can see is
There's nothing to get you worried, man. Let it come. Rocks. Really bad section, apparently. There's rocks all through here. So you gotta watch it.
Check that out, all rock.
And shallows up ahead.
Just got a putt through here. I'm gonna rip the guts out of you. Hit that. It's all part of the river, I suppose. Putting along.
It's actually nice to just putt.
But I got a
places to be, people to see.
Yeah,
look at this one coming up. Don't know which way to go.
Coming through this section up from Tullyback, it's really tricky. You've got to follow the channel in the water, and I haven't got a depth sounder, so that makes it impossible for me. So I've just got to go by eye. You can see all these ripples on the water. I don't know if you can see them or not. But wherever there's no ripples, that's where the channel is. And that's where you've got to go. I can only just putt along or I'll hit something. See the big snag coming up right there? Snags everywhere. I think once I get the robin violet, it should clear up. So I don't know if that's a snag or a sandbank or what. But it's something. That's all, see how it's all rippled up there? That's sandbank. So I'm going wide because I'm in the channel. Nice and flat. I think. Don't want to bottom out on the propeller. Haven't got a spare. It's pretty dumb, I should get one. I'm coming out of Tullyback. I'm about to go through what's called the Bitchin' Pups. Sounds pretty bad. Looks pretty bad. I'll see how I go. Apparently, when the water's low, you can't even get through. Everyone reckons the water's fair at the moment, so it should be alright. Coming through that other cutting. Holy cow. Anyway, onward. Going through the Bitchin' Pups Rapids. That's it there, I'm guessing. Well, that's it. That's the bitch. The book says to go left. Left and left. See, this is why that chart book came in so handy. Like, you wouldn't know that if you go that way, you bottom out. Look how shallow it is. It's stone underneath here.
So far so good. Apparently in the shallow water, when the river's shallow, it's impassable. It's that shallow. Anyway, I better concentrate. Going through that way, I would have been stuck. It's shallow. I think it gets better after this. I hope so. An adventure. Look at this. Got these snags everywhere. They're running like rapids through here. Tricky bit of water. I think this is Goodnight Bend. Everyone goes past here and says good night. I think. Oh, that wasn't as bad as what I thought. Hit the bottom a few times though.
Beautiful highway, the artery of Australia, Murray River.
This is the junction of the Waco River. That used to be the Murray River, but the Murray River changed its mind and started going down through Echuca instead. That's what it says in the book.
Well, there you go.
At least I know where I am now. Onward. Widened out really nicely ever since the Waco Junction. Much nicer. Back to easy going again. yet. Thought this section looked really nice. Nice and calm. Like much, but that is where the Murrumbidgee comes into the Murray. I'm just going to go up a little bit of the Murrumbidgee. So I can say I've been on the Murrumbidgee too. That's it. It looks a bit snaggy. That's it. That is where the Murrumbidgee comes in. Okay, so I'm now entering the Murrumbidgee River. This is the Murrumbidgee. It looks chock-a-block full of snags. So I'm not going to go to, go up it. You can definitely smell the difference in the water though. This water smells just different. I don't know how to describe it, but it certainly does. It sort of smells fresher. That's the Murrumbidgee. Up there. It looks from here like it's almost blocked already. So I'm not even going to go up there, I'll probably lose my propeller. Anyway, this is what I was going to do. This is a reenactment of Captain Charles Sturt. When he came out and he met the Murrumbidgee, Murray River, he said, "I was thrust out into a grand river." And this is exactly what he saw. Exactly what he saw. Coming out of the Murrumbidgee and being thrust out into a grand river, the mighty Murray. Probably doesn't mean much to a lot of people, but it means a lot to me. I think it's a special place. And this is exactly what Charles Sturt would have seen. Exactly what he saw. Do a quick scan around and then I shall continue along the Grand River. Murray River, Murrumbidgee River. And then he continued down to South Australia, of course, which is where I'm going, hopefully. I'm on the famous Boundary Bend now, which is probably, I don't know why, but it's probably the most famous bend on the river. So anyway, this is what it looks like.
All my clothes got wet yesterday from the ski boats, so I've just rigged up a clothesline on the side of my boat. Another beautiful day. Gorgeous.
Imagine, if you will, that you, that river level was higher than what it is now, and that big clump of rock right there, which covers the, pretty much the whole length of the river, was just under the water. I hit a rock back there, it was just under. Look at it. Right, onward. Thank you.
This is the sort of thing they don't show you on the TV shows. You know, the Murray's good for cruising. You know, but little rock clumps like that can be just out of the water, just under the water. And all these rock reefs, these are good ones. You can see them. The ones you can't see under the water is the bad ones. Just under there. Got to read the ripples. That piece of steel sticking out there doesn't look like much. But that's actually a shipwreck. And the name of the ship is Floria Annie. That thing. If the river was a few inches higher, you wouldn't see that. Still going over. Look at it. Graz Island. This is the thing, it doesn't look like much, but it's just plonked right in the middle of the river. Big chunk of rock. And it's called McGraz Island and it's surrounded by rock. So, you know, without these charts to know which way to navigate it, it's just a quagmire of rocks. You're gonna hit something for sure. These charts, mate. Damn. Yeah.
I guess it'd have to be the nicest part of, or one of the nicer parts of camping down the river. Every night you got to camp somewhere else. And, you know, every camp's different. I've learned to try and camp near other people, because the other night I got harassed by some wild pigs and it freaked me out a bit. So I try and camp near other people now, not in their face, but just near them. It's beautiful, mate. This is the life.
Oh, so there, yeah, the fish jumping everywhere, mate.
Much nicer houseboat conditions here than in the Echuca. Looks like better boats too. Absolutely gorgeous. Why would you want to be anywhere else? And look, watch this, when I wave, they'll wave. Everybody waves on the Murray River. Oh, he waves, but just a bit of a little wave. Everybody waves, every single person.
It's not cold. The water is actually warm. It's nice. Nice sandy bottom here. It's beautiful. Now, I need everyone's opinion on my new tattoo. What do you reckon? Do you like it? I love it. Bloody beautiful. Why would you be anywhere else, man? I got the boat all nice and clean. Give her a wash, inside and out. I'll give the change the oil in the motor later on. Both oils. There's my little camp. Heading into lock 11 now. Thank you.
beautiful morning on the Murray River. Coming into Renmark. I'm just about to gonna pull up here for a sec. At Renmark. Saw this boat on TV. That's Queen and not Queen, you know what I mean? I might actually pull up here somewhere. I reckon. Anyway, gotta go.
Gotta find somewhere to pull up.
Just coming into Piringa now. Is this winded, Nico?
pull up. Thank you.
don't know what happened. I came out this morning and waited 2 days for good weather. We've got perfect conditions, calm and no wind, but it's fog. Can't see a damn thing, so I've been rescued by fishermen.
Covered in ice and snow, there's a man, oh so old, oh so cold. In the spring the rivers flow, summertime the grasses grow, reindeer and antelope, a place they call home. Says don't come any closer, get back, I've seen the likes of you. Close the door behind you, get out, leave no trace, don't call again. The old man sits in his chair, in the sun by window there. For the world he does not care, he's seen too much pain. Born in a big city, next door to a factory, he got a job in the army and set sail to sea. Says don't come any closer, get back,
I'm the firing.
Down in Tennessee, and he raised a family, 3 girls, 2 boys. Says don't come any closer, get back, I've seen the likes of you. Close the door behind you, get out, leave no trace, don't call again. 3 girls died of disease, wife died in misery, boy set off to be heroes of war. So he was alone again, didn't hide nor did pretend, reached out for a friend, but no one, no one was home. Says don't come any closer, get back, I've seen the likes of you. Close the door behind you, get out, trace, don't call again.